Eric Bakker, the naturopath. Thanks for coming back. Let's talk about arthritis, particularly inflammatory arthritis and fungal conditions. But how, more importantly, is yeast linked up with arthritis kind of symptoms in people? Well, click below in the link in the box below, and you can just read one paper out of many thousands online that are similar. This one's about rheumatoid arthritis and yeast infections. In fact, it's well documented in history if you go right back as far as the 1920s and 30s in medical literature. You can read accounts of staphylococcal infections or even candida infections being involved in inflammatory arthritis. But a lot of doctors will still push the line, we don't know what causes it. Well, hello, they do know what causes it, because there's plenty of scientific information now linking candida, various candida species up, with inflammatory arthritis. So, but how the hell does it happen? How does it get caused? Well, some people are certainly more prone to autoimmune conditions than others for various reasons, you know? Genetic reasons come into it, and there'll be demographics, there'll be lifestyles and diets, and many potential triggers for an autoimmune reaction. But how the hell does it cause this kind of joint pain? But I was interesting reading some papers yesterday only, where patients who've had operations, for example, are much more prone to getting yeast infections, and particularly if they operate around the joints. It's not that hard for a person to get a yeast infection inside the joint. Actually, in the synovial fluid, they've even found people to have this. Now, that's a different situation because, obviously, you know, an operation, you know, preceded the infection. But what about people who've not had an operation? Well, I tend to sort of look at these people and think, what medications were they on? What kind of drugs were they taking that weakened their system? You know, what's the genetic link here? You know, anyone in the family have this particular type of arthritis? Many times pharmaceutical drugs like antibiotics are actually linked up, itchy eye, are actually linked up with this condition. So as you know, yeast can change by nature, okay? It can turn from a cell into a hyphae. Okay? It can actually grow and spread and move throughout the body in different ways. It can get into the brain, it can get into the organs, it can get into the joints. It can travel anywhere, particularly with a weakened digestive system. You know, the body's been pummeled with all sorts of crappy kinds of diets and medications, and it'll become weaker and sicker. And as a consequence, yeast will get in. I think I might have mentioned an analogy once before, which I mentioned on a video. I talk about the log. You chop a tree down, you chop two trees down, and you push one log into the forest in a dark corner somewhere, and you push another log, or the same one, you know, you cut it down, or even if you cut one in half, and put that one into an area where it gets sunshine several hours a day. Same wood, you know, same time, different locations. The log that's sitting there in the cold and the damp without much sunshine is going to get rot, decay, mold. It's going to basically fall apart. The other one there left where the sunshine's penetrating it, where it's drier, the conditions are different, doesn't seem to get affected so much apart from the underside. So you can clearly see the conditions, you know, that an organism can be put into can determine, you know, the path, you know, the path of destruction, basically. So, and it's not different from human beings. You put people into crappy diets, high stress positions. You put other people into healthy diets with lots of raw and fresh foods with low stress conditions. You know, the two logs, you can start to get, you know, where I'm going with this. So it's not different from human beings, really. It's the conditions the person's been living under, eating under, medications they've been taking. All of these things contribute eventually to, you know, a building up of the health or a breaking down of the health. And that can push a person into a yeast infection, just like it did with me in my 20s, when I started to believe that antibiotics actually were helpful for people, and I was placed on those with a chest infection, when in fact it was the beginning of ruining my life for a couple of years. I've received some very interesting comments on our channel, on the YouTube channel, with some videos regarding antibiotic-induced damage with people. You know, I've witnessed this hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of times in my clinic alone. So just be careful with antibiotic medications, because sometimes these things can be triggers or the tipping point to push someone over the edge and to push their log into the dark side of the forest, okay? So just be careful. That's my take on it anyway. Thanks for tuning in.